that, but I'll talk to you all through it now if you want to do this on your own. So your warm-up is going to be 4 minutes rounds of 5-inch rows, so nice wide feet, walk your hands all the way out and all the way back up. Then 20 toe touches, so I want you to have feet nice and wide, toes pointing forward from here, hinging over, touching your toes, nice trunk rotation through, 10 each side, and then just 10 air squats, get those legs moving. So on Zoom, we're gonna do it for 4 minutes. If you don't feel warm enough by then, keep going a little bit longer on your own. And then we are gonna get into this chipper. So this is for time, and it's super high volume on quite a lot of movement. So just gonna get as far as we can with this. big Monday bank holiday workout. So we are gonna start on 100 air squats. So you all know what you're doing with an air squat, but when we're in super high volume like this, we just wanna make sure that we are not no-repping. So if you're doing it at home, and all eyes aren't on you, make sure that you're hitting the bottom of your squat and opening your hips at the top. So we want to see you get down as far as you can, stand all the way up, open your hips on every rep. So we don't want it to turn into like a weird half squat thing where you're not opening your hips at the top, okay? So yes, we want to get this done, but we also want good form on this. If you were competing, they will be looking for your hips to open at the top on every rep. So 100 air squats is obviously quite a lot of reps. Shake your legs out whenever you need to, break it down into sets. When there's stuff like this, you'll see people change directions just for a change of scene to do something different. So maybe hit 10 squats facing forward, 10 face side, do 10 squats, 20 or whatever. Just make sure you're breaking those down when you need to. Then we are going into 100 deadlifts. So if you have a barbell and you want to use it for this workout, then go for it. Otherwise, we can use a kettlebell or a dumbbell. basically, we're not looking to go mega heavy on this. So if you've got a barbell, not looking at anywhere near kind of the top end of your deadlift, because a lot of people will be using kettlebells or dumbbells, and that's kind of more the stimulus we want. You've got 100 reps, we don't want to shatter your back before you've got a load more reps of other stuff to do. So with my dumbbell from here, sending my hips back as far as I can to the floor and back up, working your way through 100 reps, breaking when you need to. Make sure you keep that form. That should all be in your hamstrings, in your posterior chain, not pulling in your lower back. So make sure you're sending your hips back and hinging into that. Then we are going to hit 100 walking lunges or just static lunges. I wrote 100 walking lunges because, again, it gives you a bit of change of scenery, feels like something different, rather than standing on the spot. But if you are in your house, or you don't have a lot of space in your garden or whatever you're doing this, then just 50 lunges each leg stepping out. So from here, unweighted, stepping out, right into the floor, change, go again. If you've got space to walk, walk somewhere, walk back 100 reps on those lunges. if you are feeling brave and you really want a leg pump out of this, pick up the weight you're using, do it as goblet weighted lunge, but you do have 100 reps, so that's up to you. If you want to scale it up, chuck some weight on that, but unweighted for your 100 air squats, 100 lunges would be pretty tough. So once we've done that, you're on to 50 sit-ups, so our reps are halving now. So 50 sit-ups, touching the floor behind your head, in front of your feet. Then we're looking for 50 of a jumping movement. So ideally, box jumps, step jumps. If you've got a little wall in your garden, jump onto that. If you don't, then hit tuck jumps or star jumps. So 50 of one of those variations. Obviously, star jumps are going to be quicker than a form of box jump. So yeah, you'll get through it a bit quicker. If that plyometric movement isn't good for you, any knee injuries, any niggles anywhere, then just step it up. So onto, you're going to do 50 reps, 25 lead them with one leg, 25 the other. So we're looking for plyometric movement if you can. If you can't, step out on those. Then we are going into 50 alternate arm snatch. So if you have a dumbbell, kettlebell, that's what we're going to use for this. So pulling from the floor back to the floor every time, keeping that weight nice and close to you, making sure it's always returning to the floor between your feet, so you're not reaching out in front of you to get it, which would ultimately end up pulling in your lower back. So 50 sit-ups, 50 box jumps, 50 snatch. Then we're going to hit 25 burpees, so you know your burpee, chest and thighs, touch the floor, jump and clap above head. Then 25 kettlebell swings, so kettlebell swings, dumbbell swings, doesn't matter. Just get those reps done. We're looking to go overhead. If you have a dumbbell and you're not confident taking that all the way overhead, just go to eye height on those, and then 25 push-ups to finish. So if you can do 25 push-ups to the floor, wicked. Even if you have to break those down a little bit, that's your last movement, so just give that the best attempt you can. Or scale it up to, if you're in your garden or wall, if you're in your kitchen, a tabletop, if you're in your living room, a chair, whatever you've got that you can raise that push-up up onto to scale it back if you need to. So that's a big old chipper, that is a lot of reps, that's a lot of work to do for today. So once we have got that, we're going to call it a day. So that's it.